Okay, so let's enter our BIOS. We'll reboot and hit F12 or F8, delete, whatever your system may require. Okay, we're in the boot device window. Hit exit setup or enter setup. Okay, before you do anything, I'm going to go left arrow to save and exit. Scroll down, go to load optimize defaults. Okay, that'll get you probably like 95% where you need to be to get your system up and running. And let's go right arrow to the MIT tab, advanced frequency settings. This is default, this is default. You do want to change this to profile 1, extreme memory profile XMP. Advanced CPU core settings. Don't mess with any of the advanced stuff yet until you get your system up and running. I don't recommend you go tweaking anything until you are in a good place. Then save your existing BIOS setting, and then you can mess around with it. And if you screw up, you can go back and restore it or reload the previous. Exit that. Okay, system memory multiplier. That's auto. Back to MIT again. Advanced memory settings. Extreme memory profile, XMP, profile 1 from our previous page. And all this is default. And once again, the advanced settings, don't mess with any of this until your system is up and running. So we won't touch that. Advanced voltage settings. Advanced power settings. This is all default. You don't want to go mess around too much with any of this stuff, once again, until you're good. This is default. Your CPU core voltage control, chipset voltage control, once again, default, and DRAM voltage control. This is all default. You don't have to mess with that unless you want to tweak. And escape will take you back. Okay, PC health status. This is just reset case, open status, disable, enable, doesn't really matter. But the load optimize has it as disabled. Miscellaneous settings. PCI slot configuration. You can have it set to auto. And 3D Mark 01 enhancement. That's disabled by loading optimize defaults, so don't mess with that. Smart fan settings. This basically shows you can CPU, first system, third system, second system, your fans. It'll show you your temperature. You can change from normal to silent to manual, full speed. That might be too high. Let's go here. All right. Keep that. And CPU fan fill warning. Let's enable that. So in case one of our fans goes down, we'll get an alarm and we'll know. And then your fan speed, once again, normal, silent, manual, full speed. But I want to keep my eye on the CPU fan. System. This will show you your version of your BIOS, the name of your motherboard, date and time you can set. All right. Go to the BIOS tab. Boot option priorities. UEFI, OS. This is our current boot drive, and that's priority. Now Clover, I believe, handles this as well, but there may be a conflict if one set to one and not the other, you may get an error. So it's good to have an idea of what you're dealing with there. This is default, default, default. This is the Gigabyte logo that pops up when it first boots up. Fast boot, that's disabled by default. Okay, real important, Windows 8/10 features. Other OS, otherwise it will not work, and that came up by just optimizing the defaults. This is disabled. Storage boot option controls, go to UEFI only. Other PCI device ROM priority, go to UEFI only, which is network stack, that's set to disabled, and administration password, this is where you can set your admin and user passwords. Okay, let's go to peripherals. Initial display output, my NVIDIA GTX 970 graphics card. It's coming out of PCIe 1 slot. Easy RAID, unless you're doing that, don't have to worry about it. But ambient LED, you can change the modes, still mode, beat mode, pulse mode. I rarely look at the computer. I have it sitting under my desk. And legacy USB support enabled. Real important, XHCI handoff enabled, and EHCI handoff. Let's enable that as well. Port 6064 emulation enabled. USB mass storage driver support enabled. And the SSD security erase. This is I guess if you gotta burn it in a hurry, that's the way to do it. Go back, and then our Intel Ethernet connections. This is a default, didn't have to change anything, and we're up and running, so if you don't have to touch it, don't mess with it. Okay, let's check our chipset. PCH sSATA configuration. Now this is where you go and sSATA controller enabled. Configure sSATA as AHCI. SATA mode options. SATA HDD unlock enabled. And SATA LED locate enabled. Those are set by default. Now, if you have a hot swappable drive bay, you can hot plug enable them. Go through and enable all those. Escape to go back. Okay, PCH SATA configuration. It's going to be very similar. SATA controller enabled. Configure SATA as AHCI. SATA mode options. This came up as enabled. LED locate. And once again, hot plugs enabled. Back. Okay, XHCI mode. That should be auto. Some say smart auto, but auto seems to work for me, so continue to go with that. Audio controller enabled. PCH internal LAN enabled. Wake on LAN, that's set enabled by default. Real important, Intel VT for direct IO, VT-D, that is disabled. MCTP, this is enabled by default. Real important, execute disable bit, that should be enabled. And Intel Virtualization Technology VT-X, that should be enabled. Power, this is set by default, so unless you want to mess with this. But once again, I don't tweak or do anything too major until I know everything's good. And then we go to save and exit. But let's save this profile. And I got an empty slot. And I will call it Sierra YouTube. Okay, so if I have any issues later on when I do some additional tweaking, you can go back to load profiles and choose Sierra YouTube. Okay, so I'm going to save and exit setup. Save configuration and reset, yes. Okay, and that's your BIOS settings for Sierra, El Capitan, and this will also work with Yosemite Clover bootloader and Yosemite Chimera bootloader. Thanks for stopping by. Please remember to like and subscribe below, and I will see you.